Okay, good morning all. So myself Professor Hiten Mistry from S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Umrak Bardoli. Okay. So we are going to learn today iron carbon equilibrium diagram. Okay, yes, sir. The topic is on the basis of iron carbon equilibrium diagram. Okay, now as we seen in the figure, okay, don't hesitate, the figure is too long, so big, so complicated. Okay. So we are going to learn in an easy and a fine way. So just follow my given statement and steps. You can easily know what are the sections and what are the lines and what does the diagram indicates all. Okay. So now, first of all, the following phase involve the transformation occurring with iron carbon alloy. First of all, we are going to looking forward towards the transformation. Okay, so as we seen here, it is in a liquid form. We are going to learn the various section with respect to different color coding. Okay, so now the liquid solution of an iron carbon diagram. Okay, so as we see here, so I am highlighting what are the liquid section. So this is all the section that we are going to conduct here. It comes under the category of liquid sections. Okay. The region inside this is a liquid region. Okay. Now the second thing is this delta region. Okay. So let's have a color change. Okay. So as we see here in the green section. Okay. This section indicated the delta section. Okay. So which is basically known as a delta pyrite. It is a solid solution of a carbon atom. Okay. So why solid solution? Because now we are let the solid to be solidify and the temperature is bit decreasing from 1600 degree to 1400 degrees. So there is an initiation of an solidification is happening at that point of time. So basically is in solid solution of an carbon in iron. Okay, so there is a maximum concentration of carbon in delta pyrite is 0.09 as we seen over here. So let's look as talking about this point. I just so when we go in the down section, okay, we can find it. Okay, so we can find it in the horizontal direction we have the percentage of carbon and in the vertical direction we have temperature. Okay, so now here we can see that there is a percentage of 0 to 1. Okay, so it has an 0.09. so here we can find it 0.09 percentage of your delta pyrite is present at a temperature of 2719 degree Fahrenheit, which is basically 1493 degree Celsius. And at that point of time, there is a pyritic transformation taking place in the iron carbon diagram. Okay. Now, the third one is the crystal structure of delta pyrite is in BCC structure. Okay. Then after, just a minute. Which is having BCC structure and temperature having 1493 degrees Celsius. And next point is what? Talking about this phase. This year, let's say, let's change the color. Okay, let's change to blue color. As we see here is a delta austenitic structure. Gamma austenitic structure. Okay, so the gamma austenitic structure is in the section of this blue portion. This structure, this triangular type of structure is basically from alpha ion. Okay, so this blue color is basically showing an austenitic structure which is having the carbon interstitial solid solution. Okay, as we have already studied the solid solution in that it is categorized in the interstitial solid solution. Next point is your alpha ion. Okay, so what is, where is alpha ion? Okay, so same here is in blue color, there is an alpha ion. So the austenitic has an FCC structure, face center to the structure, which is permitting in high solubility of carbon up to 2.06 at 2097 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so as we see over here, so let's take it in a new form. Okay, so as we see here, there's a percentage with this line indicating at the downward section, there is a 0.2, and at that point of time, we have how much? We have 2.06% of carbon. So here we have 2.06% of carbon present at this point of structure. Okay. Now, in the austenitic structure does not exist below 1333 degree Fahrenheit, or basically we can say that 273 degrees. As we see here, it is in stage at which at this point of time we have 723 degrees Celsius. Okay, so at this point of time there is a no existence of austenitic stage, as we see here. So it will, this graph will show an upward trend. So there is a no phase available below 273 degrees Celsius, and at the final stage we have 0.83% of carbon. Okay, so as we go down at this point of time, so here we have 0.83% of carbon, which is in austenitic structure. Okay, and next thing, same, the graph has been understood. The first of all, at as this point of time, we have shown three different region. First one is your liquid region, second one is your delta ferrite, a delta region, and next one is your gamma region. Okay, so now we are looking forward to the other region. So the other regions are, okay, so talking about the cementite. Okay, so there is a basically three axis diagram. So in the vertical axis on the left side we have temperature, on the horizontal axis we have percentage of carbon, and in the right side of the vertical axis, this whole axis is your cementite. Okay, so let's highlight the last okay, so this blue color portion is your cementite portion. Okay, this line is your basically belongs to cementite portion. Okay, now the cementite portion is an iron carbide intermetallic compound having fixed composition, which is having fixed composition, which fixed composition of 6.7% of carbon atom. It is having a fixed composition in all phases. Talking about the liquid phase, the gamma phase, and XY cementite is having fixed intermetallic compound. Okay, so cementite is hard and brittle substance influencing on the property of steel and cast iron. Okay, so it is having the property of brittle structure and hard structure, which is basically influencing the property of steel and iron carbon. Okay, now we are going to talking about alpha iron. Okay, let's change the color and let's change it to brown. Okay, so now we are going to talking about alpha iron. So where is alpha iron? Okay, so here it is an alpha ferrite. Okay, so the region in between this portion, as I'm going to highlight, this portion is your alpha ferrite. Okay, so the solid solution of alpha ion having BCC structure and which is having low solubility of carbon, which is having 0.025%, as we see here, which is totally negligible to show, but it shows like here it is having 0.25% of carbon at 1333 Fahrenheit, which is basically 273 degrees Celsius, as we see on over here. Okay, so here is a 723 degrees Celsius. Okay, so alpha ferrite is exists at a room temperature. Okay, so basically it is existence at a room temperature. Now next point is your A1. So now we are going to learn about the various lines, various regions that differentiate between in the iron carbon diagram. Okay, so now first of all we are going to talking about A1. So which is, what does the word A1 indicate? So A1 is an upper limit of ferrite and cementite phase. So basically the lower region is your ferrite and upper region is your this is this region is your cementite region. The cementite phase is available in that the vertical direction. Okay, this is the cementite region, and the ferrite region is available in the downward section. Okay, so it is basically a differentiate between the ferrite and upper limit shows between the ferrite and cementite phase, and the horizontal line going to the eutrophoid point. This is an eutrophoid point. Okay, so basically it's going from the eutrophoid point and having different cementite and ferrite composition in that. Okay, so this region, let's talk, let's draw and highlight over there. This is an A1. This is an A1 line. Sorry. Okay. Now, just a minute. Okay. So this is an A1 line. Now we are going to talk about A2. So here is an A2. Let's change to color. Let's change to yellow. So here is an A2 structure that I am highlighting. Okay. So A2 is the temperature where iron loses magnetization. Okay. Where A2 is the structure at which iron loses magnetization. At basically it is at the curing temperature. But we have to note that pure iron, it's still is in alpha phase, as we have seen earlier in the allotropy of an iron. It loses its temperature and changes its structure. It does not change in the structure. It remains same as an alpha phase, but there is a change in a property which is having non-magnetic to magnetic structuring. Okay. Now the next point is of. Now we are talking about A3. Let's change the color. Okay. So now let's take a green color. So A3 is the boundary of between gamma austenitic structure and austenitic ferrite field. Okay, so it is a structure of a gamma austenitic structure. So here is an A3 field, A3 line which we have seen. Okay, so basically it shows the boundary between gamma austenitic structure and austenitic or ferrite field. Okay, now the fourth one is your A4. Let's change the color. Let's say blue. So A4, oh, it's too dark. Sorry. Let's say the point in this case where alpha changes to delta at a high temperature, the point at which alpha changes to delta, as we seen over here, there is an alpha ion, and as we go upward, as the temperature increases, it changes its temperature from alpha to delta. Okay, so this is your A4 line, A4 region. Okay, so this is basically the change, the region at which alpha changes to delta at a very high temperature. Okay, now the next point is your ACM. So ACM is over here. Okay, let's change the color. Let's change it to again yellow. Okay, so ACM is the boundary between austenitic alpha austenitic structure and austenitic cementite field. Okay, so where is austenitic cementite field? So first of all, it is an austenitic structure. Okay, a gamma austenitic structure, and this is your cementitic field. Okay, so it is the region of ACM. Let's say this is the region where there is a change in ACM structure throughout the end. Okay, so this is your ACM structure. So at that, on the left side we have austenitic structure, and on the right side we have cementitic field. So it is then region between austenitic structure and your cementitic structure, which is your ACM structure. Okay, so basically this is the basic line and formation of an iron carbon diagram. The next point is A1. So we are going to talk about A1 in a detailed form. Okay, so it is a lower critical temperature A1, the temperature of the austenitic to perlite eutectic transformation. Below this temperature, austenitic structure does not exist. As we see here and already talked about that, so below this line there is a no formation of austenitic structure. So in the iron carbon, it's changed to ferrite. And above A1 there is an austenitic structure, and below A1 there is a ferritic structure. Now talking about the A2, So in the A2, the magnetic transformation occurs from temperature at the A2 in the alpha ferrite atom. Okay, as we know that there is a ferromagnetic material, so it's changed its structure from BCC to it's changed structure to BCC non-magnetic to BCC magnetic structure. Okay, now for A3, okay, so the upper critical temperature ACM is the temperature below which the cementite start form as a result of ejection of from austenite in the hyperoptotic alloy. So as we see here, there is a cementite structure formation and it's start as a result of an austenitic emission of an hypoeutectic alloys. Okay, now okay, so first of all we have talked about the various regions and line and all. Now we are going to differentiate what are the various formation of an steel and alloys in the various carbon carbon diagram. Okay, now we are going to study about hypereutectoid. Okay, so as we have marked earlier, so is an hypereutectic steel carbon content of 0.83% to 2.06%. So here is a 0.86% and from this to 2.6% consists of a primary pro-eutectic cementite structure according to our ACM and paulitic structure. Okay, so it is the structure which is having combination of paulite, let's show the color, which is having combination of paulite and ferrite. Okay, so in a hypereutectic alloy, steel. Now as we see over here, let's take an example of an steel hypothetic structure. So first of all, now just highlight on what I am saying. So as we have already learned, from below A1 it is available in a ferritic structure, and above A1 we have austenitic structure. Okay, so now, so as we have, let's consider this dot that I am highlighting. Okay, as you can see over here, it is comes into the region of an austenitic structure. Okay, so what there is in formation, what is the internal microstructure of that formation? As we see over here, it has been highlighted in this graph. Okay, so as we see here, so when we are going to put this kind of material in an electron scanning microscope, we are going to observe in a fully gametic structure in all over the region, because it is totally available in a austenitic phase. Okay, so now as we go downward direction and comes into the, now we are come into the ferritic structure. So it is an in comes into the ferritic structure. Okay, so now during this combination, first of all it is in alpha ion. After decreasing of temperature, its temperature decreased and the structure changed to ferrite. Okay, so this ferritic structure is been elaborated in a magnetic particle way. So as we see over here, we have two constituents. First one is your alphatic structure, which is formed due to decrease in temperature, and your ionic ion carbon diagram, as it is been formed during the solidification formation at the by reduction of the temperature. There is a totally change from an internal one structure to another multistructure. Okay, now same it is for the other. Okay, so now we are going to talk about cast iron. So first of all, just look at over here, we have steel and cast iron board. Okay, so the region between 0% of carbon and 2.83% of carbon, 2.083% of carbon, we have steel structure. Above 2.83 we have cast iron. Okay, so 2.06 we have cast iron. Okay, so cast iron is in content from 2.06 to 4.3%. Okay, basically range between this structure. Okay, consists of a pre-oxidized cementate C2 ejected from an austenitic structure according to Kao ACM, as we have learned earlier, and which formed a perlite and transformed into lubricated lubricated structure. Okay, this is again in for combination of austenitic and lubricated cementic structure. Okay, now we are going to talk about A3. Okay, so A3 is an hyperactive steel which is having carbon content from 0 to 83%. It is formed in a plutotic ferrite phase according to Kao A3 and perlite structure. Okay, now we are going to assume that this object, because there isn't so much of a small region, so we are going to have an assumed picture over there. Okay, so now as we have learned earlier, this region which is having delta ion, okay, now the upper portion is your liquid portion, as we say, let's highlight it. Okay, so now we are talking about this yellow region which is having delta structure. Now we are going to talk about this liquid structure. And as we seen over here, okay, okay, so talking about this region, what is the structure formation of this region? Okay, so as we have on the one side there is a deltaic structure of a delta formation, on the other side we have liquid portion. Okay, so the formation of this phase is the combination of your delta plus liquid ion. Okay, so as we see here, from one side we have delta and from other side we have liquid. So the region between these, let's say highlighted in the yellow red color region. Okay, this red color region, this red color region is your delta plus liquid region. Okay, so this is your delta plus liquid region. Okay, now talking about again we have a deltaic structure, and here we have gamma structure in the blue form. Now what is the formation of this violet region? Yes, you are right. On the left side you have delta, on the right side you have gamma. So it is a combination of delta plus gamma. Okay, so this region will be combination of delta plus gamma. Okay, same it is for this region. On the one side we have liquid region, on the right side we have gametic region. So this is the combination of liquid plus gamma. Okay, so same it is for the others all structure. Okay, so this is the basic classification of an ion carbon diagram. Okay, so hope you understand. Thank you so much.